A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 23rd March, on the front page you have, "Let Lokpal probe bribery diary, Congress." So Congress has stated that, you know, payments to BJP leaders have been made, and this was found in the notes kept by Yediyurappa, the former Karnataka chief minister. So he says that Congress President Rahul Gandhi says that this should be investigated by Lokpal. Here you can see. So there are media reports that Y.S. Yediyurappa had allegedly paid bribes to the tune of 1,800 crores to BJP's top leadership. Then below you have, center bans JKLF under anti-terror law. So this is Jammu and Kashmir Liberation Front. So it is led by separatist Yasin Malik. It's not a terrorist organization, it's a separatist organization. They want a separate nation for themselves, Jammu and Kashmir. So there are some such parties too. So this party has been banned under anti-terror law, Unlawful Activities Prevention Act 1967. Then on page 5 you have, coming, a law to empower forest staff. So a draft has been prepared of this legislation. Now it will be sent to key state forest officials for comment. It has not been made public yet. But this legislation is to give India's forest officers the power of a civil court to prevent offences. Then on the editorial page, the first editorial is Evasive Mayawati. So it says, her sense of friends and foes is predicated on winning back the larger Dalit spectrum. So this is regarding BSP's Mayawati, how it forms alliances. And next is the Kerala alert. So this says, there needs to be greater surveillance across India for the West Nile virus. So we recently saw in news how a child from Kerala's Malappuram district died of West Nile virus. So this talks of higher alert now. The lead article, next stage in the great game. So this is regarding Taliban. So it says, defeatism will hurt India's interests more than the Taliban's return to Kabul could. So Taliban was the ruling party, as such you can say, a ruling entity in Afghanistan when US invaded Afghanistan in 2001. So Taliban has been one of the important forces against which US has been fighting. Recently we have seen how talks have been initiated with Taliban. Russia has also facilitated these talks. US Taliban had their talks, you know, separate talks in Qatar too, without the inclusion of the government in power presently in Afghanistan. So there have been developments going on, because it is essential that we ensure Taliban does not get hold of Afghanistan again, because it implements extremely conservative laws in the country, and the terrorism is also said to be emanating here. So now what has happened is that India has to play a lead role here. So that's what is emphasized on in this case too. Then next is revolutionary ideas that live on. So this is regarding Bhagat Singh. It was 23rd March in 1931 when Bhagat Singh, Rajguru and Sukhdev were hanged to death. So it says, this article says, revolutionary ideas that live on. So it talks of Bhagat Singh's intellectual bequest should be a beacon of light to build a new India. So he had written many pamphlets and, you know, booklets as such. So that is spoken of. Then on Saturdays, you have this Ground Zero coverage on the op-ed page. So today it is Art in the Marketplace. So this is regarding Kochi Muziri's Biennial. So here you can see an inclusive artist-driven art, which is practiced in Kochi. It's called the Kochi model now, and it is driving interest among art institutions worldwide. Then on page 8, you have, Supreme Court may not admit diary as proof. So Yediyurappa diary has to meet multiple conditions before it can be accepted as proof. This is in the case of, bribes being paid by him to various BJP leaders. So this is the Yediyurappa diary. So whether it can be admitted as an independent evidence or not is detailed out here. Then this is Statistical Institute submits report on VVPAT to Election Commission. So Election Commission has stated that the Indian Statistical Institution will give its recommendation of how, you know, VVPAT verification should take place. So now it has submitted its report. So we had seen this entire case. Election Commission said that only one random VVPAT verification would take place per constituency, while opposition parties wanted 50% verification per constituency. Then on international page you have EU gives UK new Brexit deadlines. So this is regarding the deadline being given till May 22 by European Union to UK for exiting from European Union. So it says that if Theresa May's government is passed by the MPs, exit will be delayed till May 22. If it fails, UK will be given time till April 12. Then below you have Syria vows to take back Golan Heights from Israel. So this is regarding Golan Heights, which actually belongs to Syria but was taken over by Israel in the war in 1967. So, you can see. So, it was captured and annexed in 1981. It is not recognized internationally, but Golan Heights is under control of Israel. And now, Syrian government has vowed to take back this Israeli-occupied region, Golan Heights, which belongs to it. Then this is North Korea pulls out of liaison office. So this is North Korean decision just few hours after US imposed fresh sanctions on North Korea. And below you have Sri Lanka signs loan agreement with China. So Sri Lanka has signed $989 million loan agreement with China's Exim Bank to build a highway linking the center of the Indian Ocean island to Chinese built seaport in the south in Sri Lanka. And then Italy is set to become first G7 country to join Belt and Road. So Italy has joined Belt and Road initiative of China. So it becomes the first of the Western nations, the G7 nations, to do so. Then on business page you have government earns 85,000 crore from disinvestment, overshoots target. So this is regarding the disinvestment target for the second consecutive year has been overshot. So, the government has reaped 85,000 crores from exchange traded funds. So, this sale was announced and now you can see it has been successfully put into effect too. And government has earned a large amount with sale of these ETF, exchange traded funds. We had seen earlier too, the PSUs of the government, there is exchange traded fund of those PSUs. So, sale was announced here of shares which resulted in money being garnered by the government. Then this is state's overall deficit set to decline in financial year 2020. So this is SPI economist saying that healthy growth in gross state domestic products, rise in GST collection and cut in revenue expenditure are some of the factors which would result in overall deficit declining. Then on the last page you have monkey birth, a step in saving fertility of boys with cancer. So this is an experimental study undertaken by US researchers in which immature testicular tissues are taken from the baby monkey before it hits puberty and it is used to produce sperms for boys. So boys with cancer. So this is an experimental study being undertaken. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website aasha.com. You can download the PDFs and also enroll for the detailed current affairs video course. Thank you.